Hey YouTube, Zach Colonius here. Welcome to another video, and welcome for those of you tuning in for the first time. So it's been a while since my last video, and probably some of you, hopefully some of you, may be wondering, where the hell is this guy at? You know, where, what's he been up to? And sure enough to say, for the past several months, if you will, basically I've been engaged in the martial arts. I've been practicing in Wing Chun, Kung Fu, and American Kempo Karate. And I've been doing these both martial arts for about, well, American Kempo I've been doing for about 2.5 years, whereas Wing Chun Kung Fu, I've been doing it for about, let's say, two years now. And I have to admit, as a prepper, it's probably one of the best investments that I've ever done. As some of you, if you don't know, I am a amateur prepper. I've been a prepper for about three years now. The catalyst that basically induced me to become a prepper was Hurricane Sandy back in 2012, and it's been a very interesting roller coaster, if you will. I've been a prepper, say, about probably since 2013 or so, and it's been a very, very interesting journey. Aside from the martial arts, prepping has taught me a lot about myself. It's taught me a lot about people. It's taught me a lot about how society functions and how fragile our society is. And again, I'm not going to go into great detail as to why, but it suffices to say our society operates on a very thin thread, if you will, or several threads, and once you start cutting those threads, unfortunately society can just go, our society can go into chaos, if you will. But nonetheless, so the martial arts, which is the focus of this video, I've been practicing now the martial arts for about 2.5 years, very, very interesting journey, and it's a journey that I wish I'd taken many years ago, but nonetheless, the fact that I'm on this journey now, it's satisfying. It's a satisfying reward to myself. But the martial arts, I think, is a vital self-defense in general, and the martial arts, they go hand in hand, and I think it's probably the most vital tool that a prepper can have. Because think about it this way. When you run out of bullets, when you don't have anything else but these things, hands, your legs, well, that's, you gotta go primitive, and you gotta go hands-on, if you will. And knowing how to defend yourself, knowing how to protect yourself, having the ability to protect yourself, is probably one of the best gifts that you can give yourself. Especially for females going into college, in my opinion. In my opinion, it's probably one of the best tools that you can have. Because let's be honest here. There are a lot of idiots in college. I'm not trying to say this to put down men, but also females, that basically just don't know how to behave. And sometimes, unfortunately, you have to go hands-on. It's not by choice, but because of necessity. And my thing is, and if I was a principal or president of a college, I would mandate in my opinion, I would mandate that martial arts be taught in junior high school and high school. That way, when people come out in the world, that they have a ability to basically defend themselves. Because remember, when seconds count, police, civilian police, are minutes away. And that's if they get to you in time. So, take up a martial art, take up boxing, take up jiu-jitsu, take up something. Give yourself what I would call a fighting chance. Because on the streets, anything goes. And when it comes to rapists, burglars, serial killers, they don't care. The law, when it comes to the law, and breaking it, they have no problem doing that. So that's why give yourself the edge, in my opinion. Martial arts, at least from a kung fu perspective, I think has been a huge asset to me. It's one of those things. It's one of those goals that you put in the back of your mind, and you go, you know what? Somewhere along the line in my life, I'm gonna do that. I want to do that. And now that I'm older and I have the finances for it, boom, I'm here. I am, and I'm doing martial arts, and it's fun. Yes, I'm learning how to. Yes, I'm learning how to hurt people. Yes, I'm learning how to defend myself, but I'm learning. And that's the critical part, is learning. This quest for knowledge as a prepper, that's one of the things that separates us, in my opinion, from the rest of the populace, is our quest to know for knowledge to enhance ourselves, to help better ourselves. And I think as a prepper, that's probably one of the most important things that you can do, is to seek knowledge. So that way you can better yourself as far as how you prepare, better yourself as how you defend yourself, better yourself mentally and how you see the world. I mean, these vital things. I wish when my brother, eldest brother, started doing prepping, I wish that I took him serious when he told me, or I should say, when my family told me what he was doing. I wish I took it serious. Because for a while, like I said before, I thought he was crazy. Or that he was going crazy. Then when he explained it to me, and explained why he became a prepper, and why he's doing what he's doing, it made sense. Being a prepper, I think, should be something that every, should have, there should be one prepper in each family. In my opinion, because you just don't know. The way our society operates, the thin thread that it's on, I think it's vital, in my opinion, that someone in your family be a prepper, and make it a family activity. I wish, my family operated along those lines, but they don't. But so far, right now, it's only me and my eldest brother. And I'm cool with that. I really am. Does it mean that, that we're better than everyone else? No. But it does mean that we have a more, hopefully, likelihood of surviving should the shit hit the fan. God forbid. So that's my spiel, and that's where I've been. This January, I go for my test for my second degree brown belt in American Kempo Karate, and I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a very interesting journey, and I look forward to this journey, both as a prepper and martial artist practitioner. So with that being said, guys, definitely you will see more videos, and happy belated Thanksgiving. Please stay safe. And always remember, be proud to be an American.